we have got some of the students from this film school who are here with us. Ria and Monica approached me a few weeks ago and they said they really love to interview me and get my input on a film that they are making around the passion gap. And it's like, what's that? And I came into the studio and I said to Natalie and to Nick, what is the passion gap? Educate me around this.
Did you hear the news on the radio today? People have agreed to give their love away. I can't wait to be there.
Fashion gap.
Fashion gaps.
Do I think it's sexy?
Sexy, yes, I like it.
Sexy, as lekker, as lekker. Yeah, whatever.
Taylor, you're from Joburg, where the passion gap is not nearly as prevalent as what it is in Cape Town.
Doesn't even exist.
Does it not?
You guys have the beach and the passion gap, and then
and the mountain.
And the mountain.
I'm Chantal Pedro. I won't reveal my age.
My name is Iaroy de Breinikus, 21 years old.
So what do I know about the passion gap?
The word passion can say a lot to you, you know.
A passion gap, so you can see your passion gap, you know, it's like your feet and your eyes.
That's taken to be very common amongst colored people, where the front teeth are either removed or they are somehow absent.
Some of the urban myths that I've grown up with hearing about is that it only happens with coloured people in the Western Cape.
I'm not comfortable saying that it's something that has to do with colouredness.
Beauty obviously is culturally determined and culturally structured.
It is amongst the coloured population, so maybe there's something there.
I can't say coloured anywhere else in the world. I don't know if you know this, but it's true. Like when I went to the UK, I learned this, you know. Speaking to a friend of mine, Jeremy, and we were talking, and he was like, so tell me, Trevor, tell me, where are you from, yeah? I said, well, I'm from South Africa. He was like, oh, wow, South Africa. That's amazing. So what, are you Zulu? So I said, no, I'm not Zulu, Jeremy. I'm actually colored. So like, oh, don't say that. Don't say that. That's racist. You don't use that word, Trevor. Don't call yourself that. Right, don't use that word, all right? You're free here, brother. You don't call yourself that. Right, it's not the right word to use. You don't call yourself coloured. Call yourself mixed race, all right? Mixed race. That's a PC term, mixed race. On the flip side, you come to Cape Town and say to a coloured person, hey, are you mixed race? They'll probably be like, you're massive mixed race.
There are known cases of cultures where the rites of initiation for both men and women actually include the knocking out of the front teeth. And this happens in places like Indonesia, in the East. And for them, I don't think it's necessarily a question of just a passion gap that is about sexuality as such. This is really an initiation into your culture. This is an initiation into adulthood.
The people in Mrs. Plain and the coloured people in general throughout Cape Town didn't have access to proper dental care.
My personal reason for a passion gap was when my tongue was by a fruit due to eating lots of candy while I was still young, you see.
There's a class element to it.
If I, as a white woman, were to have my teeth removed in my community, people would think there was something really wrong with me. They'd probably book me to Falkenberg Psychiatric Hospital.
The passion gap may be now and may have been in the past more prevalent amongst the lower income groups.
The doctor for a bit cheaper for a ton, so I get all the same thing 9 tanden getrekken, which means it's 18 inspuitings. And toen by the last inspuiting kom, toen kon die my nies. Actually, would come to my nose.
In the early 70s, 60s, we had a few white dentists coming into town into these areas, and all they used to do is take out teeth.
I know that back in the day, I'm talking about really back in the day, sort of, what's it, maybe like the 1950s, 1940s, dentistry was an expensive luxury. It was something you couldn't really afford.
There was no advice given to the people, there was no other treatment. So you used to have 50 people lined up, and they would actually just take out the teeth. So if you had one rotted tooth, people would actually say, why don't you take out all the teeth?
It was a community dentist that went around to the schools and was like, ah, you know, let's just sort you all out one time.
Ping, ping, ping.
And that was, you know, so that's how a lot of people lost. And I think at my
I don't understand why it was those teeth, though. Just why those only.
The front teeth are the most apparent. If you're gonna have a gold tooth put in your mouth, are you going to put it in one of the back teeth? Who's ever going to see it?
I don't know where did it start, but like I said, it's mostly growing up, it's going into puberty, and now you show, now if you got the passion gap, you show that you're all that, you're now bigger, and yeah, you're much older now, because that's a statement that you make now.
So your story is that originally it started off in jail, where you'd be able to give better oral sex to men if you had your teeth out.
Exactly.
And then you came out and you had the status, you could be identified as a man who'd been in jail.
Yes.
And kind of a real man, because you do men and you do women as well.
That's exactly
it. Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
Somebody told me some time back that it's sexual as well.
It's a wonderful thing that people do in order to advertise their sexuality and their beauty.
Youngsters say it's just so passionate to kiss if you have a passion gap, because of the feeling that you get.
Yeah.
I will measure that my tongue is fitting exactly in that gap.
I haven't come across it where a patient has told me it's better for kissing and stuff like that, you know. But I do suspect that a lot of these young children are sexually active and have oral sex and stuff like that.
Young man, it's my last year of a row come. Now, as he man's no person get it, and the fellow inside for a week. Nou, wat is het, een vrouw mee eens een passion gap het? Toen zei ik voor mam, ik is baie jammer, maar ik ga dit ga ik nu die camera zien.
The reason that they remove their front teeth, and more specifically, I've always been told that women do this, is to be able to perform oral sex better on a man. That without teeth to interfere in the process of taking in a penis, the woman would be guaranteed to satisfy the man.
So apparently, kissing or is supposed to be more pleasurable.
I've always thought that head would be more pleasurable. By head, I'm referring to a blowjob, of course. Or yes. Fellatio, I should say. Fellatio.
Yes. Because you don't have that niggly, what's your fucking teeth?
Yeah, yeah. That's what I've always thought to myself. I've always thought, you know, was that booming shot? Okay, yeah.
There definitely was a nudge, nudge, wink, wink associated with it. It definitely had something to do with sexuality.
If it's associated with sexual activity, a person who has his or her front teeth removed is signaling to another person that they are sexually ready, that they are sexually matured, and that they are engaging in sexual activity. So this could be some kind of, if you want to put it bluntly, a signaling mechanism.
It's kind of your branding, or what I call body modification, that you're doing in order to be much more sexual, or to be found sexually more attractive or more appealing, and that you would in that way get a man.
It wasn't unusual to find a young person with two gold teeth or three gold teeth, because it used to make them look smart.
Gold in the tongue is my accessory. But my teller, like, as a smile, can we go outside?
I also want to fit in, so I went to go put gold on my own teeth. So now it looks like I also got a passion gap. So now I'm also part of the clique.
I see, yeah, the music caps are me, so man. I see, yeah. That's very spookerig.
The worst thing is I'm always talking to these like the older colored ladies. I just find they're very frisky, you know? Always come up to me and they've got this thing. It's very difficult to concentrate, like, you know, when you're looking at someone who has a top lip that moves unobstructed. And she's breathing in and out. And I mean, the first time I saw it, I was confused. I was like, is that her gum? I was like, that just doesn't seem right, you know? She's looking at me, she's like,
I know you. I know you, ne? No. It's like, nah, man. Tell me like that, man. I know you. I saw you on the TV. You're shaking your cushion. I was freaked out. She's like, turn for me. Let me see your cushion. Really strange. I was really freaked out. Because she was very strange, but sexy at the same time.
People have tattoos, but they put them in places where they are visible sometimes. Right? You don't want to put tattoos everywhere where some people do, but most people put tattoos on visible places. So when you have put adornments like gold teeth or even false teeth or rubies in your teeth or your teeth being filed down or just being knocked out for some kind of initiation, right? To signal or to receive that signal, it has to be, or to broadcast that signal rather, the signal has to be, or the sign has to be in some place that is immediately apparent to people. People have to encounter you for the first time, and when you smile, they see, oh, but that's you.
It's like an in thing, a fashion statement that you make.
It was a fashion statement.
A fashionable thing?
I had dolphin's fist on my tooth, and then I took that off, and then I put this the L and the two gold teeth in. And you get different shapes, different types. You get aliens faces, you get dollar signs, but go for the dollar signs into a certain gang.
Okay, gangsters, nge gangsters. Ezinye gangsters uhlulana noni. Ngeke zaweza ba okay Tina, sishango L Tina. Yabo.
It has a lot to do with peer pressure. It has a lot to do with the gangsterism in the area.
Abanye bashange stars, ama Americano, ama ndondoni zininsi mose gangsters ekhasi, yabo.
I think it's part of the part of the culture of the gangs not to have front teeth.
Because of the gold and the tick that is on the move now, guys actually they rob you because of your teeth. They want to take your the gold, they take your whole teeth out of your mouth, and then they just take the gold off and then go and sell the gold for some drugs.
Don't perpetuate that myth. People are not robbing each other for false teeth. Please, guys. You see, who said this?
I was like coming from town center on my way home, and then I had a cell phone, and he wanted the cell phone, and then when I spoke to him, he saw the teeth, and then he said he wanted that also before he hurt me. And then I'm like, no, va branded and stuff like that. And then he said, Hallo uit jou mond dit, so I said no, but is my eie tande, it kan nie uit. I was like crying, no, I can't go out. It's my own.
That, you see that Mitchell's plan gig, that's just, come on. People can't go around robbing, there's hardly, you won't make any money. There's no money in a tooth worth of gold. There's no money, 20, because the most you can go, you wouldn't even go 24 carat, it's too soft.
It's not 18 carat, it's 24 carat.
Some say it's culture, some say it's a gift pack. I'm like, this shit is too messy. That shit is definitely not sexy. But I ain't trying to go that colored route. I'm gonna leave shit black and white. Get it? I ain't trying to go colored, I'm gonna leave it black and white. Revelation advertisement, the fish down with the fish gap. In the texture ramp, they can look to AKA front loader. So where's the disc?
The media will dictate what you should look like. And of course, what kind of sexuality you should be engaging in at a particular age and stage in your life.
Beauty is not something that we actually see. Beauty is actually the absence of certain things.
Focus on bridging the gap, really. And
that's what it's about. That's what it's about.
Finding a way to understand this, you know, rather than finding its origin.
If there's a fish gap, then it's smooth. Smooth. It's definitely a no-no sexy thing. It's not.
It's natural, yeah. It's who I am.
No.
No, but I don't think any gap is sexy.
I think they think they are sexy.
I think there's a gap on a human
no,
being that's sexy.
There's no gap on a human being that's sexy.
I think that people who are confident and people who feel good about themselves and their bodies and walk in their own light are sexy. And if it means having a passion gap, then you have one.
game, stalk her blaze, she duct tape. On my horn, right, it's tap as a thorn. Black bimbers, but drop her in like a devil. And big one buyer, some corn, she's a buyer. And I move the can into my beat. No paint in the front, my mission is not complete. My rhymes are standing for your world, or be beat. No, see no evil, yeah, no evil. Break your beans, you see, don't see, girl, and the days are stutter. Forever, you want the basement, and pain blotter. Believe it, was moments locker. Nooper, in soccer, drag is a gebeurtenesser. She's double buster, and your